difficulties, because literally it happened, you know, after, just before I started college. So I've always worked with some, you know, physical restrictions. But so I don't know really how my work would be different if I didn't, because I can't really reverse time, and I don't know if I would make different things or if my thought processes would be the same or, you know. But, you know, if you're used to something, you don't think about it really, you just get on with it, I guess. You know, even a person with a disability is multifaceted, and they're thinking, you know, simultaneously they're thinking about lots of other things as well. You know, they're thinking about their life, they're thinking about, you know, all sorts of things. So it's not, they're not just about their physical disability. So it would be, I mean, not entirely honest to just say that's the only thing I ever think about. I did the picture of Dorian Gray, which is Oscar Wilde's picture of Dorian Gray, because I was, obviously because of my own body, and I was interested in age and time and mortality and all those questions. So, and the picture of Dorian Gray is something that captures all of those issues that we think about in terms of life and death and aging. And so I find it fascinating. I think, you know, you're thinking about really compelling things that you want to do, and you do them, but until you've actually got that out of your system, I guess you can't move on, you've got to do it, so.
It's good, yeah, they always look perfect, the costumes. Yinka uses really good costume makers.
With the costume, it's become something else.
We'll add two balloons, yellow and orange, and we can add them over this side here. There's small little pieces on the finger here that need to be just touched up, and on the other side as well.
Yeah, got those.
I'll take this shoe away with me as well today, and there's little studs in it that shouldn't be there, and it needs to be dyed. The sole should be dark, yeah. Right. We'll get rid of those.
And the foot?
The foot needs to be brought forward, yeah.
So it's sitting flat on the floor rather than...
Yeah.
Lifting up.
So the ball of the foot is forward. They're just calling me, so it's like... Hello? Okay, they've arrived.
I mean, I'll just... stand back a bit to have a look. Yeah, that's looking, it's looking good. I'll just have a look here. Hold on.
So there's two more balloons to be added.
Okay, yeah.
So if we made those orange and yellow, maybe?
Orange, yellow, and can you add a black?
Black?
Yeah.
Actually, okay. You know what? I changed my mind about black. And the reason for that, actually, is that the head being black, I thought, you know, that would be two blacks. And I think that might be... that will take away from the strength of the black down there.
We just have a few little things that we're going to tidy up with the hands and then the foot also, so that the ball of the foot is flat on the base plate.
So at the moment his heel's flat, but his ball is in the air, raising up.
Okay.
So it'll give more weight to the foot if we... or more balance to the foot if we can bring the ball of the foot forward.
But I don't want it flat on the ground, though. The foot is okay, kind of being slightly up like that.
But surely if he was trying to balance on his heel, he wouldn't really be flat on his...
No, that's what I'm saying. I like it that way. It's good.
Phew. I'm going to cross that off my list.
Yeah, it's good. I mean, I know that, you know, it's natural to want to think about what you could actually physically do. But with an artwork, it's in the realm of fantasy. It's not what you can actually physically do.
Yeah.
So comparing it to what a person can physically do doesn't make sense for an artwork. Because it's not, you know...
Yeah.
It's about doing the impossible. It's not about the possible.
Got the heads all wrong, if you are.
Yeah. VIP. 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 VIP.
I wanted to do that at that time because there was a lot of protest art, but a lot of it was quite sort of miserable and dreary, really. And I felt that I wasn't miserable. You know, of course, I don't like what's happened to my own history or African history or the history of colonization. But, you know, I was brought up in a fairly comfortable surroundings in Africa, and I wanted to poke fun, really, as opposed to being the victim. And I felt that, you know, just dress up and have a good time. That's a way to respond to it. So that's what I did. So I do have my own way of approaching things. You know, I think parody and humor is a good way to deal with some of these things. I think it's nice to see, you know, other black artists doing very well. I think it's, you know, and again, as somebody coming from Nigeria, it's not a particularly unique thing for a Nigerian because, you know, everyone's black in Nigeria. So, you know, if a black person does something, you just take it as normal. I mean, there's nothing, it's not news. But of course, I understand that in this context, it might be perceived as news, but to see it as news is also a form of discrimination in a way because it's lowering expectations. But I don't mind being lumped together or not lumped together, you know, as long as I'm seen. So, you know, I'm quite happy with whoever I'm lumped together with. Stephen. Okay.
Here we are.
Wow.
What do you think?
That's looking good.
Right at the center in the front room, of course, where you belong.
It's really great, actually, that you've got it just on its own in the middle.
Yinka, I didn't know this at the time, but he was trained as a painter at Goldsmiths. And the first work I saw really was Double Dutch. It was like no other language I had seen in painting. This idea of painting on African textiles and playing around with patterns and paint and the juxtaposition of the two together really entranced me. and enough to reach out to him and to start a dialogue, and that's really how it all began.
I met Stephen at the beginning of my career, and he kept faith with me and trusted me, and that enabled me to do the most incredible things. Because actually, it's not like Stephen discovering somebody like me, that then the work eventually goes into museums, and that's what the general public will kind of see. So, I mean, I found myself, you know, showing in Trafalgar Square on the fourth plane. You know, if I hadn't had that early support, none of that would have happened, you know. And also just very basic emotional support, you know, kind of supporting you, even when you're coming up with crap ideas and your work is no good, you know, there's a constant, there's somebody encouraging you when the work is bad also, and also when the work is good. Actually, as a result of Stephen's support, I've been able to support a lot of younger artists too. I mean, I have a project space in my studio, and I've shown over 100 artists so they can do experimental work and so on. But I wouldn't even have been able to serve other people if I hadn't had that kind of support from Stephen.
It's exciting, it's fun, it's engaging. It's everything a work of art should be.
Yeah, I mean, it's a celebratory piece. But I also wanted it to be inclusive of everybody in the gallery because, you know, it's the 20th anniversary of the gallery. And so the globe head actually has names of all the different artists. So it's meant to be an inclusive piece, but an exciting piece, because after all, you know, you can't have a party on your own. So, you know, you celebrate with others.
I think that art movements are always made by others, really. Artists don't really, you know, you don't wake up and say, you know, I'm going to be in a movement today. I mean, no artist ever does that. You know, I think people kind of lump you together and say, right, there you go. That's a movement. I'm very interested in exploring the poetic and the imagination more. And so a lot of the works, some of them will be childhood memories, but they're kind of dreamy and quite surreal. And yeah, so I don't quite know how that work will evolve, because I'm only at the beginning of all that at the moment. So we'll see what will happen.